I thought I was going crazy, you know? And like, I realized that I wasn't the one that was crazy. I realized that it's the system that was built against me, you know? And like, I'm not supposed to be talking about this. And that's the corruption of it, because like, me just saying it is absurd. And I want people to open up their eyes and realize that I'm not wrong, you know? I'm just an open-minded individual, and people should be more open-minded. If we're trying to build up our lives to have material things, and those don't satisfy our needs, what are we living for?
Around him, so partially I feel it's my fault, and that right there is my internal war. The reason why I gotta feel these external flaws, the reason why I can't heal these eternal loss, the reason why I gotta feel this survivor's remorse. And here's a message to his fam. I know y'all got emotional trauma that I understand, but I couldn't fuck with. Y'all try to tell the world I wasn't who I am, when all I ever try to do was lend a hand and give the fans the thing that they demand the most. King Capital to fucking go. Why? I'm just trying to get my nigga hurt, get him what he deserve.
This one is for you, This one is for you, This one is for you,
Yeah, and R.I.P. my cousin Junior B. Y'all ain't know too much about him, so it's up to me. This is legacy with the world. It kills me to think you'll never meet my baby girl. And when I lost June, that hurt me in the worst way. He even died 2 days before his birthday. Damn, it brings tears in my eyes. My nigga really never made it up to 25. That's why I'm thanking God every time I open my eyes at the fact that we alive and we feeling these vibes. Cause we be feeling these voids. Part of me got destroyed when I lost my boys. It's like I lost my voice. It took me all of this time just to put it in song, because I'm still dealing with the fact my niggas is gone. Write their names up on the cloud, cause that's where they belong. As long as I live on, it'll forever be known. This one for you. This one for, yeah.
This one is for you, This one is for you,
No, you'll forever be known.
This one's for you, This one is for you, This one is for you, This one is for you,
Hey, I'm off the Deleon neat. Deleonist. So I'm gonna make this quick, you know, past the black lid, back on that shit. True story. So I'm in New York, one of my first times, and I'm playing my one of my first albums for the big homie, and he got these kids in there. They just on skateboards. I'm like, yo, it's super cool. This guy got the kids out here, you know, keeping the kids off of the streets, right? So fast forward a year later, I go back to New York, and then I meet this kid. He's like, yeah, man, I don't know if you remember me and my homies, the pro era. Crazy. I was like, oh, yeah, what's your name? He said, Capital Steve. So I said, okay, for sure. Fast forward, my boy Doe called me. Doe Burger. And he called me and said, yo, you heard these kids the pro era? Joey Badass? I'm like, yeah, I met the kid, Capital Steve. They crazy. Fast forward another year, so I'm on tour with Joey. We've been 47 ever since, man. We got that shit tatted on us, man, for life, man. Church on the move, man. Yeah. Everything come back around full circle.